As you can see here, I'm assembling my Raspberry Pi. As you know, I do a lot of projects with microcontrollers, especially ESP32. Because ESP32 has a Wi-Fi and Bluetooth modules together, it can communicate with other devices very easily, enabling many projects. To do more diverse projects, I want to use Raspberry Pi in my project. The Raspberry Pi I will be using is a 02W. It has a very small form factor and sells for 15 bucks from the official sellers. My 02W is all done. Since 02W has only one port that can be used except for power, a USB hub HAT was additionally attached. Also, this housing case includes a heatsink, so I bought this and attached it together. It's my device, so I made it in my style, so you don't have to do the same. The 02W includes a mini HDMI connector, so you can easily connect it to the external monitor. The product I will be using is a 7-inch display with a capacitive touch. The resolution is 1024 by 600. I wanted a bigger touch monitor, but they are too expensive, so I gave up. HDMI to mini HDMI cable is purchased separately. The cables that need to be connected here along with the HDMI cable are display power and touch. To sum up, if you need to connect an external monitor, having a USB hub is a good idea. So I use the USB hub HAT. Now let me connect the power. I have already installed the Raspberry Pi OS 32-bit on the SD card. Various rings can be installed, but let's start with the most basic OS. Also, I'm testing the booting time. Here is the welcome screen. Cool. If it's the headless, I would have been able to see this screen. Finally, the login screen appeared. It took about 25 seconds. Wow, a booting up was faster than expected. I think this is great. Here we are. Touch works fine. Let's play a video from YouTube through the built-in browser Chromium. I have speakers connected to the display so I can hear the sound as well. The browser is very slow. It seems that the 02W's RAM should be more than 1 GB, not 512 MB. Let's play LG's OLED black video, which many people use when testing their monitors. Wow, it's too slow. I will have a 5 times the speed for a while until the actual video comes out. I think it's ready to play. The video is set to 720p 60fps. I know it won't play well on the 02W, but I'd like to see how well it can play. Anyway, I'm gonna play it full screen. Thank you. How was it? Frame drops occurs in between, but it doesn't seem to be the worst. If you have a project where video playback is important, it would be nice to have a product with a Raspberry Pi 4 with 8GB RAM. From now on, let's test the USB web camera. I bought it on Amazon and it was very cheap. It was a promotion price. Not sure, but I found it from Slack Deals. Honestly, I don't know which company's product it is because I only checked the price. Also, I checked, it has an autofocus and 1080 full HD resolution. That's it. It's a very generic product, so I know it works on all platforms without installing a driver. Let's connect right away. I have work to do on the console, so I will also connect my USB Mac keyboard and mouse. Even if I have a touch screen, I need a keyboard and mouse too. In the end, I ended up using all of the USB ports. Let's look at the list of the connected USBs. I can see my Apple keyboard and the Logitech Unifying receiver on my Apple keyboard hub. You also see the Arc International camera. This is the camera I have connected now. Now that the device is connected without any problems, so we can try connecting this camera in VLC. Open your VLC. On top of the menu, select the first menu, Media, and select the Open Capture device. The video device name should be the Dev Video Zero, and click the play button. Cool, it comes out, but it's quite slow. It's slow because it's acquiring images at the current maximum resolution of 1920 by 1080. In order to acquire full HD images at 30 FPS, you need to connect via USB 3.0, but 0 to W only has a USB 2.0 interface, that's why it's slow. This time, I set the output resolution to VGA 640 by 480 and acquired the image again. Now it's much better. At least, it comes with 30 FPS in this resolution. It's very smooth and doesn't frame drops at all. Also, autofocus works well. Of course, it works well when the subject is more than a certain distance. In general, the web camera is placed on the monitor and aimed at the user, so it should be at least 10 cm away. I think we can connect this webcam with VLC streaming and use it as a surveillance camera. To check the FPS more clearly, let's try to acquire an image with the web camera using OpenCV. Python OpenCV can be installed very simply via apt command. I will explain again in the OpenCV project. The first resolution to test is VGA 640 by 480. As expected, the lower the resolution, the faster it gets. On average, it's output at about 30 FPS. This test is 800 by 600. It comes out about 24 FPS. Not bad. This test is 1280 by 720. This time, about 12 FPS is output. It's getting slower. It can be helpful because it's USB 2.0. The last resolution I will test is 1920 by 1080, which is the maximum resolution of this camera. The size of the acquired image is larger than the maximum resolution of the screen I have. It's acquiring images at roughly 4-5 FPS. As you can see from the results, if you are doing a project for image processing, it's better to choose Raspberry Pi 4 with 8GB RAM rather than this Raspberry Pi 02W. I chose this first for a very simple project. This is a microcomputer, not a microcontroller. In ESP32, if a program was written in C or Python, in Raspberry Pi, it's possible to create a program with various languages. I'm not sure at the moment, but it looks like more interesting projects could be possible with ESP32 and Raspberry Pi together. I will share my project with you through my channel. Thank you for watching. See you in the next project.